mean go warn the spirit menders? Do you know how long I've been looking for that thing? And I'm just gonna let it slip away? I can still go after it. Why can't you and Zero go warn them?
Yeah, let's send the possessed guy and his nerdy spirit fanboy friend to warn him. That'll work out just great.
Leo's right. Best case scenario, they ignore us. Worst case, I have to watch them kill Leo.
And Nahi.
Right, and Nahi.
Fine. You bring up a pretty good point. Come on then. Chester? The wheat field. V. What was that? Is everyone okay? Yeah, we're all right. Good, good. What was that? It's kind of hard to explain right now. Just know that everyone is in a lot of danger. Is that the thing that killed my father? Are you going after it? I have to. I'm coming with you. What? No, you can't. I can't. I think you'll discover that I most capably can. Now, don't try and stop me. Then, if you come, who's going to protect everyone here in Meteor Valley? I know that, but I have to avenge my father. Or you mean, revenge your father? Look, Chester, your father wants you to stay here and protect everyone here in Meteor Valley. You're right. Gotta save the living first. That's what he do. Thanks, V. I should probably go warn them bandits, too. But just so you know, they're outlaws. Sounds like someone's been spending a little too much time with Dennis Rivers, fella. Wait. You know Dennis? Nothing. Just look, I have to get going, okay? He and I go way back. Now hurry on. We got work to do. Come on, guys. We gotta get going. Dakota!
V, what are you doing here? I thought I told you shouldn't come back here, especially with him.
Hello?
I know, but your village is in danger.
Danger? What?
There's a monster loose in the valley.
A monster? You must be mistaken. That's not possible.
I know it sounds crazy.
I've come to expect that from you. Do you remember what happened the last time I listened to you?
But don't look at me. It really was your fault when you think about it.
I've gotten into enough trouble with the chief thanks to you. Sounds like you just saw a spirit.
Dakota, I know what I'm talking about. Look, I know I don't have the best history, but you have to stop being so skeptical and just trust me. I didn't have to come here if I didn't want to help.
She's telling the truth. There is a monster in Meteora Valley.
You're right. I know the chief is suspicious of anyone outside the tribe. But as spirit menders, we should be more welcoming of outsiders. If we're going to survive in this world, we need to become a part of it, not hide from it. I'll get you a meeting with the chief.
Good.
What are you going to do?
I don't know.
V, these are spirit menders we're talking about. They used to be monster hunters.
I know, but Leo was right. We have to let them know that they could be in trouble.
And if they find out you're a monster?
I don't know. We'll just have to deal with it when it comes up.
Well, that sounds like a great plan.
You guys stay here. I'll be right back. Thanks for taking the time to see me. You should be thinking Dakota, but it's the least I can do. You are the one who found my Luma, after all. Now, what is it you wanted? Dakota mentioned you had something important to tell me. So? There's a monster loose in Meteor Valley. A monster? There hasn't been a monster in Meteor Valley for over 1,000 years. Even my ancestors have only heard rumors of them. They're gone, vanished for all time. I'm telling the truth. Okay. What makes you so sure? Just... Look. You're a monster? Yes. Do you believe me now? Yes. I can see now that you're telling the truth. This might explain why the valley's aura has been so... crazy. But because of a monster? Wait, you're not going to attack me? Ha! Attack you! Is that any way to treat a guest? Don't be ridiculous. If you're determined to find a fight, I would be more than willing to accommodate you. But why would I want to attack someone who has helped out our little tribe? These days, it's rare to see any help from the outside. Oh, I see. We will, however, hunt down this monster and kill it. Dakota, gather what men you can and meet me at the gate. If it left town, it can't have gone far. Wait! You can't! Don't do that! Don't? The blood of old hunters still flows in my veins, and I do not intend to fail the oath of my mother swore on this day. We will defend this valley of monster or spirit, matters not it, what it is to... We will defend this valley, monster or spirit. It matters not to us. But, look, you...
Hello guys, welcome back. The new up.
But, look, you... You can't. This monster is my responsibility. I'm the reason it's here, and I have to take care of it myself. You? So be it. But I hope you'll let us help regardless. Dakota, go to my house and bring back my dagger. For our guest. She'll need it. Wait, you really don't have to do that. Please, I want to. It's the least I can do for the woman who brought Luma back to me. Now, can you tell me if this monster has fed recently? Yes. On some forest spirits and maybe some humans. And you're strong enough to defeat this monster. I have to be. You are resolved, then. Good. Make sure to find Dakota before you depart. May the stars protect you. Thank you. I remember this.
Fee. Here. This is what the chief wanted to give you.
Huh? What is this?
It's the chief's spirit glass dagger. It was used for millennia to, hunt down monsters.
Thanks, Dakota. But I'm not sure that I can accept this.
I know. But can you really afford to take any chances? Spirit Glass is rumored to pierce through the thickest monster hides.
Rumored?
Well, no one's tried to test this out in the last 1,000 years. Look, if you're going to fight the beast, you'll need the right tools. Take it. Please.
Thank you, Dakota.
You don't have to thank me. Just come back alive. Good luck.
And to you, my friend. Thank you.
So where are we going?
Excuse me? We?
Yes, we. You don't plan on fighting that monster all on your lonesome now, do you?
No. I'm doing this alone. It's far too dangerous. Or did you forget that thing almost killed you, Leo?
That's why I'm going. I want to make sure no one else gets hurt.
What does Nihi think?
Oh, he thinks it's a terrible idea. But it ain't up to him. You may be a terrible friend, Fee, but... You're my friend, and I ain't gonna let you go it alone.
What about you, Zero?
Leo's right. You shouldn't have to do this on your own. We're here for you.
And?
And this is a monster we're talking about? A real live monster. Do you know how many people have seen one this day and age? This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Of course I'm coming.
See, there's that nerding out thing again.
It is not.
Thanks. Both of you. Is that Fluffers? Hey!
That's right, ma'am. It is I, Commander Thancred Fluffers of the Cottontail Rabbits Brigade. Thank the stars I was able to find you. Is M'lady safe?
Wow.
Something the matter, ma'am?
No, it's just I didn't expect you to sound so, official?
No time for that now, I'm afraid. I have dire news. Our tribe has been attacked.
What? Attacked? What? By what? Did you happen to look at it? What was it?
Of course. I'll never be able to forget either. It was a terrifying creature. I thought I'd be dead if it wasn't for the Forest Guardian.
What?
He's engaged with the monster as we speak.
Fluffers, where is this monster?
Commander Fluffers, and the Kreen came at us not too far from our burrow. Hurry there, please! Now, I must go to see my lady.
Oh no.
Hurry!
You guys stay back. Hey! Golem! Are you okay? Say something!
It's you again, Ravenhair. I fear that my time in this realm is ending.
No! Don't say that!
I discovered what was devouring my people. But I was unable to defeat it. Unable to protect them.
But what's going to happen to the spirits of this valley?
Do not worry about them. There is a successor. The Forest Maiden of the Bunny Tribe.
Luma?
She will take up the mantle of the Guardian of the Valley. I only hope she is ready. I am sorry I will not be here for her in this world where monsters will reign free.
Do you know about us?
I could tell the moment I laid eyes on you. I am wise beyond years past your disguise.
Where's the monster? The one who slayed you? Maybe we can save you.
You cannot. My time here is up.
This is all my fault. I was the one who allowed that monster to leave our realm. I was the one who caused this entire mess. Our king punished me for my banishment, and I never meant for this to happen. I am so sorry. I am truly a horrible creature.
A horrible creature? Do not let the name you are given change who you are and who you want to be. A monster to me is merely a race, not a horrid creature as the humans have named you. Remember that. Goodbye.
No!
Shoot, this ain't good! You can say that again!
It's looking at both of us.
V, run! No, don't run! Save one of us! Don't listen to that spirit! Save yourself!
I can't! They can't take that monster alone, but I can't reach both of them in time! Oh, what do I do?
Now it's your time to decide. Should V protect Zero, or should she protect Leo? In the previous episode, had Fee decided to go and find the monster herself, she would have been unsuccessful in her search, and would have come back to find the spirit menders fighting the monster themselves. Now, think about the consequences of this new choice. Good luck, and thanks for watching.